That's a perfectly reasonable reaction.
Listen, I just needed some time to clear my head.
Oh, you needed some time? Well, that's what you got, isn't it? You spent all last week with Robbie.
His name is Roby.
Roby?
You know what? I'm not going to be part of this jealousy.
Well, excuse me, but I'm pretty sure that's the only thing that keeps this from being only a friendship.
I'm done with this. Us. Whatever you want to call it. Come on, Roby.
Alice, no!
Hold on. This thing was just working 5 seconds ago.
I gave you $10,000 to produce a video on dog nutrition. And what have you done? You've squandered my money. You've turned in this piece of crap, this film art crap. It's angered me. And it's angered Princess too. I find this video disgusting. You, sir, are disgusting. That's right. It's a good point, Princess. Princess just thought you should know, sir, that your career is over.
Well, terrific. Oh, and by the way, Steinstein, Princess is a dude. Just thought you should know.
No dogs were harmed in the making of this show. I think he pooped. Have him put down. Welcome to The Slate. I'm Katie Pomegranate, and this is take 3, VFX. Show me what you got. That's it? Let's do this! This just in, there has been a mutiny in ancient Rome, and Cracker is dead. All right, let's check in with our traveling correspondent, Larry D. Air, at the post-production house, Pixel Farm.
I'm Larry D. Air here for The Slate, and I'm at Pixel Farm in Minneapolis to learn a little bit more about visual effects. Let's go take a look.
I'm here with Jason Ho. We're gonna play some billiards.
Give you guys a little tour, starting off with our pool table here.
I'm wondering, how is it that you were able to render this so realistic?
Color correction.
Took little 3 and 4 seconds takes of the baby reacting, did little morphs between them, so it looks like continuous action.
Glass table, very, this is big, this is part of it.
What about this one?
Oh wait, no.
Did all the special effects, the framing, the lighting, that's all 3D lighting. And then created this, it's not smoke, it's energy.
Now you say that right as Hagar's doing this, I don't know.
Yeah. Music for the Milwaukee Brewers.
That's a chef on meth.
Overhand project for Target for the Nintendo 3DS.
Is that realistic? It's hard to tell in here what's realistic and what's not.
Magic fact.
So, Jason, you've been working at AI for how long?
About 2 years.
Okay, and you've been working at Pixel Farm for about a year?
Yep.
Sounds like a pretty good life, my friend.
Yeah, it's good.
What's happening here?
Oh, you know, the magic.
Yes, I figured. Everywhere I go in here.
Dig it!
Cadillac CTSV.
Sweet old Wurlitzer you got. So thanks for inviting us into Pixel Farm, Jason, and showing us around. Is there anything you might like to tell anybody else they need to do to get in with a place like Pixel Farm?
Save your money.
Okay.
I don't know why that would help. I just thought that would be a good idea to save money.
That is a solid, that's just solid advice.
You know why you could save money? Because then you could get a nice tie, maybe, for an interview. Actually, you wouldn't wear a tie to an interview here.
I haven't seen a single tie.
No.
Here. Pixel Farm, no ties, sweet do.
Sweet do, hair do, do it now, dude.
My time at Pixel Farm was over. The Magic Factory had given me a look beyond the camera,
and into the high-tech world of visual effects. I learned much about green screens, dancing, hairdo do's and don'ts, snacks, and the fine art of the high-tech. Jason Ho's tour through the studios provided a glimpse behind the curtain, and I left with wide eyes, an open mind, and singed hair. I sure hope that doesn't hurt my chances of scoring an internship. For The Slate, this is Larry D. Air, on location at Pixel 4.
Dude, my egg, not your egg. My egg, don't touch. Alright. Want to splash me water?
Last weekend, at the Pantages Theater, Harry Solomon forced a group of people to watch another one of his greatest lists of all time. Here's what happened.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for coming. Tonight, I'm going to show you the top 10 most influential films in visual effects, in my opinion. Number 10, Sky Captain and the World of Tomorrow, the first film to use nothing but green screen. Number 9, Sinbad and the Veil of Mists. It's a stupid title, maybe why you haven't heard of it, but they're the first to use motion capture. Forrest Gump, the first to incorporate archival footage with the actors. The young Sherlock Holmes, the first to use a full CG character. 2001 A Space Odyssey, the first to use retro-reflective matting. I don't know what that is, but they used it for their desert. There's Mary Poppins, the first movie to incorporate animated characters with live-action characters. Old Man and the Sea, the first to use blue screen. Metropolis, the first movie to use models with mirrors so actors could fit into those models. Then, number one, A Trip to the Moon, first movie to use visual effects, 1902. Hope you enjoy. Have a good night.
What, no Alvin and the Chipmunks? Your shit's weak. The squeakle was the bomb. Buckle your seatbelts, folks. This next one's a real doozy. Comes from AI's own Conrad Flemming. It's a nice, juicy segment on the house.
Welcome to Box Talk. This is Jim Craig here. Today to talk to us from a visual effects major, we've got Conrad Flemming. He's going to talk to us about his new idea, Ashland.
Well, I started Ashland out in History and Trends in Visual Effects with Leif Smith. It was just a concept, an idea. Plots came out of it, characters came out of it, and pretty soon I had a series that I was going to start.
So what you're saying is you got a lot of people involved in it.
Yeah, it crossed over into Production Fundamentals into a team project, and we created this video right here.
Let's check it out. So, great clip, by the way. I mean,
hey, thank you.
I'm pretty impressive.
Yeah,
where do you see it going?
It wasn't just me who worked on that.
Oh, really?
Robert Young also worked on it and helped a lot.
Where do you see this project going? What's the kind of the dream?
Well, I want to make it into a webisode series. 10-minute segments, each in different episode of Ashland, and they'll all tie in together. And we may, if we get enough interest from it, we'll continue it.
All right, Mike. It seems like you got a great idea here.
Yeah, thanks.
I look forward to seeing more Ashland.
Yeah.
Thanks for joining us on The Slate.
My pleasure. I love this show.
Jim Craig from Box Talk. See you around.
What? We're doing the interns thing again?
Do you have any medicine for diarrhea, sir? It's coming.
You just got VFX'd. What up, Jose? This has been Katie Pomegranate for The Slate. Tune in next week when we learn how to skin a rabbit to make a windscreen.
Great, I love Aslan. I mean...
Yeah, that's the porno version. Yeah. I'm sorry about your accent. There.
Sorry, it just... I'm like, Aslan, it's hard, eh?
What's that?
It's hard to say Aslan. It's Aslan, is it?
Yeah. Apparently that's I understand, you know.
I work
with your speech impediment.
Yeah.
And the fact that you talk around a cardboard box.
We've been a lot of places, actually. In this little butte.
Yeah?
Nicknamed Sheila.
Sheila?
Yeah.
Sheila shipped you over here?
She did.
Yeah. Did you have a green card before you got here? I hope you did. No.